Hello VSDC family! We are over the moon to announce the release of our major new update, VSDC 10.2. This release is packed with fantastic new features and significant improvements to your favorite tools. Especially for everyone who loves adding speedometers, compasses, and other cool gauges to their videos, because now you can do it all right inside our editor. Ready for the details? Let's dive in! New features in GPS telemetry. Let's start with the GPS telemetry magic in VSDC 10.2. If you're already familiar with the GPS path, you'll love this. You can now add a map underneath your route with just a single click. Simply select the telemetry object and choose your preferred style in the map type property. Click on Download Map Image and the map automatically trims to fit your journey. Fine-tune its zoom, position, and borders. Another major improvement in VSDC 10.2 is the ability to display the path for just one specific clip in your project. It is incredibly easy. Just select the desired video clip in the Sync to property and hit the synchronization button. Now for the really exciting part, creating those beautiful gauges. With VSDC 10.2, we've introduced two fantastic new tools, Telemetry Widget and Telemetry Text Value. These let you build your own custom gauges and displays. It is a big topic, so we'll have a separate, in-depth tutorial on building them from scratch. For now, let's focus on the quickest way to get eye-catching results, using ready-made templates. Just add a video with telemetry data and export this data. Then simply drag this telemetry file from the resources window onto your timeline. It will instantly open the telemetry templates menu. Inside, you'll find templates neatly organized by type. Each group contains options for pro subscribers as well as premium templates available for separate purchase. If you've already bought the bundle, all new tempos in VSDC 10.2 are yours. Otherwise, you can buy individual collections or the complete premium bundle. See the link in the description. Let's try one. Pick a speedometer. Their main differences are design and max speed. Click Add and a telemetry widget object will appear on your timeline. Adjust its duration and for the best quality when scaling, enter the object and use the zoom effect. Now, let's make it work with your data. Click the telemetry object on the timeline and go to the properties window. The key setting here is telemetry resource, as it defines which GPX file to use. If you added the template via the resources window, this is set automatically. But if you use the scene buttons, you'll need to manually select your file. Next is Sync 2, which links the telemetry data with your video. By default, it is set to order. Here's the simple trick. Just click Apply Setting and the speedometer animation will automatically match the video segments on the same timeline level. Remember to press Apply Settings anytime you move the widget or video layers. Finally, the Metric Units property lets you choose your preferred measurement system. And that's the basic setup you need in VSDC 10.2 to start working with templates right away. Metadata and markers. Now let's talk about another set of great features in VSDC 10.2 designed for perfect organization. This update lets you add video metadata, create chapter markers, and set a custom thumbnail for your exported file. To add metadata, go to Project Explorer, choose your project, and click All Metadata in the Properties window. Fill in the fields, choose a saving format, and upload a cover by clicking the folder icon in the thumbnail section. Don't miss the Include Markers option. It ensures your chapter markers are saved in the final video. Creating a chapter marker is a breeze in VSDC 10.2. Just place the cursor on the timeline, click Create Marker, Select Chapter Marker as the type, set its name, and you've just split your video into chapters that are saved on export and can be recognized by other devices. You can also edit metadata right before exporting in the Additional Settings tab. Just keep in mind any changes made there are temporary and won't be saved back to your project file. Preserving fonts when packing a project. With VSDC 10.2, you can work on any PC without worrying about missing fonts. Now you can save projects with all fonts included. Simply enable the Save User's Font when Project Packing option in the Options. When you pack your project, VSDC 10.2 will collect all your media files together with the specific fonts you used, making transferring your work between computers completely worry-free. Exporting individual scenes. What if you only need to render part of your project? VSDC 10.2 lets you quickly export a single scene or a specific selection of them. The quickest method is to go to the Project's Explorer, right-click on a scene, and choose the new Export Scene option to render it immediately. For more control, use the main Export dialog. Navigate to Export Project, open the Additional Settings tab and disable Join Scenes to a Single File. It reveals a list of all your scenes, allowing you to check just the ones you need. A handy trick. Right-click in the source file area to quickly select or deselect all scenes at once. And remember, you can apply the Set Markers function to each scene individually in VSDC 10.2. Support for new codecs. VSDC 10.2 significantly expands codec support across the board for a more professional workflow. Interface improvements. We're always working to make your editing experience more comfortable. In VSDC 10.2, we've refined the timeline color scheme to feature more muted tones and added new colors for better object distinction. To apply the new scheme, go to Options, Timeline Color, and select Reset to Defaults. If you love your current setup, remember to export your settings first in case you want to return to it. To all our users who have been waiting for an Arabic interface, your patience is rewarded. We're happy to introduce full program localization in Arabic. Simply choose it in General Options and restart VSDC to get started. Other notable improvements. We've packed VSDC 10.2 with several more handy tools. For instance, in the Video File properties, you'll find three new buttons designed to effortlessly restore a clip's duration if you've trimmed it and then change your mind. The first restores the left edge. The second restores up to the red loop mode marker. And the third restores the right edge. The Create Snapshot function has also been upgraded. Now, if your object contains other elements inside, you can capture them all by simply selecting Yes in the dialog box. Finally, the Export tab has been refined for speed. You can now quickly rename your file, copy the save path, access recent file names from a drop-down, or instantly open the export folder. As always, VSDC 10.2 includes significant under-the-hood work to enhance performance, stability, and fix various reported issues. So, update to the latest version VSDC 10.2 using the link in the description and let us know what you think of all the new features in the comments below. Thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video.